Hi everyone, in this video I'll be showing you how to find the maximum and minimum value present in a table or column in MongoDB by using Node.js. So let's get started. So currently I'm having here a super simple code. So let me explain it to you. Here I have imported two libraries. They are Express and Mongoose, and this is my connection to my local MongoDB, and this is my schema. I'm having like three values: name, mark and ID, and this is my model, and these are some of the like standard operations. I'm having post, fetch, post with increment, put and fetch and delete. So if you want to like watch the entire tutorial, please click on the icon that is appearing on this video. You can watch the entire tutorial and continue with this. Or if you want only to get the largest and smallest value present in a collection, you can just watch this video alone. So if you are not having this code, just pause the video and type this out. Okay, I think till post operation is enough, so you can just basically like pause the video and type this out. So once you have typed this, just come down over here. Let me just have a comment as, first I will show you how to get the minimum value or the smallest value present in a collection. So I will just have it as get min over here. So here I will be having app dot, so app corresponds to this express one, okay, basic stuff, app dot get. The reason is because we are only going to fetch the value, okay, we are not going to like update or post any data. We're just going to extract the value from our MongoDB database. So that's the reason why I'm having here get. So let me just have a path as get min, comma, it's going to take the request and response and arrow function over here as well. And here we need to make use of our model name. So in my case, my model name is mon model. So I will just go here where you like specify your schema. That's the model. So I will just do mon model dot find, just open circular bracket, dot sort, and here you need to specify your key name or your column name. So here I am having like three keys or columns, that is name, mark and ID. First I will sort based on mark because that is of type number. So I will go with that column mark. Just open double quotes and within that specify your key or column name, which is mark. Like, be careful with the spelling and the cases of the letter, okay? Like, you need to be careful with that as well. So that's fine. And just come out of that, it's going to be dot limit one. So let me just explain to you this entire code, okay, first. So what this does is that it basically sorts our mark column, okay, mark key. So by default it will be sorting in ascending order, okay? So it's going to be like smallest till the largest number, and this limit basically like constrains to the number that is specified over here. So let's suppose say that we are having mark values as, like in this case, okay, in this case I'm having mark values as 300, 150, 150, like that, 100, like that. So let's suppose consider that there are some collections and mark values are 1, 2, 3, something like that, 4, 5, 6. So this is something like that. So after sort, everything will be in ascending order. So if the limit is 1, it just fetches the first value, and if the limit is 2, it fetches the both the values, and we will be getting the entire like document, okay, entire data of that particular mark. So here let's suppose say that I am having these many values and the least mark is 10. So when I run this particular code with the limit as 1, I will be getting this entire thing, this entire data. I won't alone be getting this mark. I will be getting this entire data corresponding to this mark. So that's the good thing over here. So let me just now run it and show you. I think you will have like a better understanding. So this is like the nutshell of how this works. So it's going to be dot execute, and here we will be having a callback function. It's going to be error, comma, value, or the data that is being sent, okay? That's the minimum value that we are getting from our MongoDB database, and arrow function over here as well. So if any error, let's just console.log the error, and I will have a else block over here. It's going to be else. I will just send the data, response.send value, okay? All right, so this is good, I guess. Let me just now save it and start the Node server. So it's going to be Node. My file name is main.js. Yeah, it's on port 3000. So now let me just go to my Postman. So here I'm having already a post operation. Let me just check whether it is working. I will go with D over here and I will just put, what to say, like 55 something, some values. I will just click send. Yeah, I'm getting posted. And if I go to my compass, yeah, I'm getting the 8th value as that. So it's now working fine. So now what we need to do is we have to come down. We need to have this path. So just copy this and you're going to go to postman and you need to be like really careful over here. First thing, from this post, you need to change to get, because we have specified over here as app.get. So really important thing, and just have none over here and just change the path to slash get min or the text that you have specified over here. Okay, that's fine. So now if I just give send, so here you can see I'm getting some values over here. So let me just clarify you why I'm getting this particular data. So we are basically like trying to find the smallest mark, like minimum mark present inside our entire collection or table. So if I now just go to my compass, so if I just now scroll, I'm having 300, 150, the least mark is 10. So we need to be getting the entire data over here. So it's going to be C106 and that's what appearing over here. So let's suppose say that we want to like, I will show you like, get the least 2 marks, okay? So for that, just change the limit as 2. I'm just saving it now. Control C and I'm just running it again. So this time we will be getting 2 documents or values, okay? So let me just go to postman and again send it. Yeah, so here you can see I'm getting 2 values. The reason is because 10 is the lowest mark that is present inside my table and 50 is the second lowest mark. So if I just go to my compass, so here you can see 10 is the lowest and 50 is the second lowest. And I think if you have the limit as 3, we will be getting this mark as well. So this is how basically you can find the minimum value. And this also works for ID as well. If I just now change this to ID and I will go with limit as 1. Saving it, Control C to stop. And if I rerun it again, so this time I'm going to find the smallest ID present inside my table. So if I just now send it. Yeah, so here you can see I'm getting ID as 1, which is the smallest. So let me just stop this now. And now let us see how we can find like the maximum value. So let me just change this itself. Okay, you can like have type it out separately. Let me just put get max over here and I will change it as max. So the code is going to be exactly the same. The only change is going to be just add a minus sign in front of the column name. So I'll just put a minus over here. So this basically will return us the value of the ID having the largest value. So in our case, it's going to be, I have 55 as the maximum one, I guess. And this also works the same way. So this will basically now sort in descending order, that is largest to smallest, and it will just fetch the first value. So that will be the largest among all. So now let me just run it. And let me go to my postman. Here I will put get max and sending it. Yeah, I'm getting ID as 55. And if I can do the same thing for mark as well, saving it and run it. So I think I need to get this one, ID5BB1000, because that's the maximum mark. So if I just now go to my postman and run it. Yeah, here you can see I'm getting 1000. So now what if you wanted to access only this particular mark value? You don't want this, all this other stuff, okay, other data of that particular ID. So what you can do is, I just went here and I just did val of 0. So this basically will give us the first item, okay, the first JSON that is present inside it. So we won't be having this list over here. But I got an error while trying to do it. So let me just now save it and stop it, rerun it again, and now send it. So here you can see I'm getting the JSON. So in order to access this particular key, what we can do is we'll just go put dot mark. I think this is the like just normal way of doing it, but I'm getting an error. So if I just rerun it and now send it. So here you can see I'm getting an error when I try to do that way. So if you know any other reason why I'm getting that, please comment it out. But I also found a solution to it. So if I just go here and type JSON in caps dot stringify and just enclose this, and if I just now save it and rerun it again, and if I just now go to my postman and send it, so this time I'm getting the output perfectly. So in case if you want to like access individual values, you can like go with stringifying that particular entire JSON itself. and it works. Or else if you are good with the whole value, like the whole document itself, you can just pass value. Okay, that's your choice. So I hope you have found this video useful. I've also done many other programming videos in C, C++, Java, Python, Node.js, React.js, MongoDB, SQL queries. So do check other videos of my channel. Subscribe me. Thanks for watching.